Hi, my name is Danny Garrett.
And I'm Mark Peterson.
And we're fisheries biologists with the Washington Department of Fish and Wildlife. And today we're going to teach you a little bit more about channel catfish here in the state of Washington. Unlike their cousins, the yellow, brown, and black bullhead catfish, channel catfish can only naturally reproduce in the Columbia, Walla Walla, Snake, and lower Yakima rivers. So the department has to actively stock these fish in order to have fisheries that persist in our lakes. We're also going to talk about some tips and tactics for you beginner anglers to help you come out here and be successful. So Mark, where are we going to be fishing today?
Well, today, Danny, we're fishing at Roses Lake, which is located about a mile and a half north of the town of Manson in Chelan County. And Roses Lake is one of about 28 channel catfish management waters statewide that have been stocked since the late 90s using warm water program funds.
We realize that since we've only been stocking since the late 90s, that you may not be aware that this opportunity exists. Not only do channel catfish make awesome table fare, but they also grow to some impressive sizes, the state record being well over 30 pounds. So we hope that today's video will give you just enough information for you to come out here and enjoy this exciting opportunity.
First fish of the day right here feels like a decent fish. Oh yeah. Feels like a solid fish. Absolutely love these catfish. They really fight well. Even the small ones give it everything they have. Oh, he's really giving me a tussle. Roses Lake channel catfish right there. All right, we just took a quick weight on him, 8.1 pounds. Really nice channel catfish right there.
Oh yeah, that's a nice channel catfish. That's a good eater size. That's what we've been waiting for right there. Come on. There we go. Get in that net. Beautiful. Boy, I tell you, these channel catfish are so pretty. Let me turn this fish sideways, you can get a good look at it. Just an absolute gorgeous channel catfish. When you hold these fish, you want to grip them up near the head, and you want to watch out for their pectoral and dorsal spines. You'll notice he has a spine at the leading edge of this pec fin here on the left side, and then the leading edge of the dorsal fin. The smaller these fish are, the more dangerous they get, because they can wiggle in your hands more. They're not as docile as this fish here, and those spines are much sharper. So make sure you be careful with small fish. How to identify a channel catfish is easy. They differ from the bullhead catfish species because they have a forked tail. You can see that clearly here.
Let's take a minute and talk about stocking. This is one of 2,500 channel catfish that was stocked in Roses Lake in the last week. Predation on small channel catfish is very high, and we purchase these fish at 10 to 12 inches like this to help reduce the predation by largemouth bass. As you can see, Danny's holding a fish that came from the 2011 stocking about 3 years ago. As you can see, they grow quite a bit in 3 years.
So let's take a trip across the mountains now and look at a recent stocking effort in King County at Green Lake. Hello and welcome to Green Lake in North Seattle. We're here to stock channel catfish today. And I'm joined by district fish biologist Jenny Whitney and also the manager of our Arlington fish hatchery, Dave Whitmer. You folks at home might be wondering what makes a good channel catfish management water to us biologists. Well, one, Green Lake is not connected to free-flowing or anadromous waters where we have salmon or other species of conservation concern. Two is forage base. Like so many other mixed species waters in Washington, Green Lake has a number of species, including pumpkin seed, rock bass, and brown bullhead, all of which make excellent forage for growing channel catfish. And third is distribution. We'll put up a map right now, and as you can see, our 28 channel catfish management waters are well distributed around the state of Washington. So hopefully there's one close enough to your doorstep that you'll come out and take advantage of this opportunity. So Dave, are we ready to stock channel catfish today?
Absolutely.
Fantastic, let's do it. Thank you.
Okay, another nice eater fish right here. Nice. There we go. All right, that's a nice little eater catfish that I just caught. Now looking at this fish, I would say that this fish is probably from our 2011 plant. So this is about a three-year-old fish, and it's grown quite a bit since we stocked it. Very good size to eat. Danny, we've had pretty good success today, and it seems like fishing for channel catfish is pretty straightforward.
Yeah, it's really pretty basic, and that's the exciting thing about channel catfishing is it doesn't take a lot of complicated technique or gear to get involved with. But we are going to focus you on a couple of our keys to success today, namely habitat, gear, and bait. Now for habitat, you folks just getting into catfishing might be aware that catfish are nocturnal feeders and will move more during the middle of the night actively seeking food in the shallows. But they also can readily be caught throughout the day. Now to target daytime catfish, we're fishing over deeper water in 15 to 20 feet, expecting these late summer, early fall channel catfish to be below the warm water layer, below the thermocline. Now as it gets closer to dark, you might expect these fish to start moving around the shallows, and we would move our baits progressively in shallower, seeking those fish. If you don't have a lot of success and you're in a boat, move around the lake throughout the day. You're going to find that these fish won't move around much, but once you do find them and put the bait down there, you're going to have a lot of success. So Mark, tell me a little bit more about your rigging.
All right, well, for Rose's Lake, I'm using just a little bit heavier rod and reel than I normally would because the catfish in here can reach up to 18 plus pounds. So I'm using a salmon steelhead type spinning rod. I'm using a reel that's capable of holding a couple of hundred yards of 15 pound test line, which is what I'm using today. And I have it rigged with a sliding egg sinker to a three-way swivel, using a short leader coming off the side of the three-way swivel and a longer one off the end. At the end of each of the leaders, I'm using an octopus circle hook. 4-aught, 5-aught works pretty well. That's what we're using today. This is an octopus circle hook, and what you can see on that is that the point bends right back toward the shank of the hook. And the reason that that's so effective for channel catfish is you can put that bait out there, the fish grabs that bait, and when it swims off, the hook goes right to the corner of the mouth and self-hooks. So you don't really have to be right there to set the hook every time. Danny, let's take a minute and talk about bait. How many different kinds of channel catfish bait can you think of?
You got your doe baits, your stink baits, your blood baits.
Dip baits.
You got chicken liver.
Worms.
You can use a hot dog.
And you can use shrimp.
Well, who's going to use shrimp for channel catfish?
Well, we are, and we're catching channel cat.
Good point.
Well, I would encourage you to go out and look for a channel catfish bait that you feel comfortable with and that you get confidence with. This is a bait that I've used for a long time, and I have a lot of confidence in it, and so that's why we're using this today.
Well, Mark, it looks like we had an awesome day of channel catfishing here at Rose's Lake.
We did.
Channel catfish is an exciting opportunity here in Washington, and we encourage you to come out here and take advantage of it. They grow to impressive sizes, making for some exciting angling action, and they make excellent table fare. On Rose's Lake, there's a 5-fish limit on channel catfish, but this will vary from lake to lake, so make sure you check your regulations before you go fishing. We've had a great time teaching you a few things about channel catfish, and we hope you'll come out here with a family member or a friend and learn the rest.
And remember, when you're on or around the water, be safe and fish Washington.